why do we associate being gay with decadence? Why do we associate sex scandals with the upper class? Let me introduce you to the Cleveland Street scandal. This subject's been chosen by my backers on Patreon. If you'd like to join them, you can also boss me around. So, we're in Victorian London, it's the summer of 1889, homosexual behaviour is still illegal between men. You remember that summer. And the police are investigating a theft at the telegraph office. They search one of the messenger lads who works there and they find he's got a lot of cash on him. Like, more than you would expect a messenger boy to have. And he says, no, I didn't steal it. I got it from my second job, working at a male brothel. So the police investigate the brothel and they start discovering its clients, including Lord Arthur Somerset, equerry to the Prince of Wales himself. Somerset runs the Prince of Wales stables, and I know that doesn't sound like a highfalutin job, but he's not like mucking out the stables. He's in charge of buying the prince's horses, so it's a trusted and well-respected and high-class position. Now, Lord Somerset is questioned, but he's not arrested. The arrest warrant is actually blocked by the Lord Chancellor, and by the time it's finally put out, Somerset has fled the country. Now, at first, this isn't a huge news story. The lads who worked at the brothel got pretty light sentences, and none of the clients were ever prosecuted, until a journalist called Ernest Peake gets his hands on the story. He starts asking, why did everyone get such a light sentence? Was there maybe a government cover-up? Were the authorities trying to hide the involvement of an even higher-ranking client? Perhaps the Prince of Wales' eldest son, Prince Albert Victor. Now, nothing ever actually comes of this. Prince Albert Victor dies a couple years later, and historians haven't found any proof linking him to the brothel, but it cements in the mind of the public the idea that homosexuality is an upper-class thing, like gout, and they use their power and wealth to corrupt working class lads into it. This is going to be seemingly confirmed for the public by Oscar Wilde's trial a few years later. And lest you think this is an old-fashioned way of thinking, we still love a story that's shaped like this.